Hey, everybody, welcome back. We're just going to talk about a small little news item from ASML and IMEC. Little piece of information that helps us understand what is in store for the future for ASML and how this affects the semiconductor industry. Many semiconductor investors are already very well acquainted with ASML. It is the largest equipment maker in the semiconductor industry. They fall into the wafer fabrication and assembly equipment portion of the industry. ASML provides primarily EUV lithography machines or DUV lithography machines to manufacture semiconductors.
And ASML is often called a monopoly of sorts within this segment of the semiconductor industry. As Casey said, a primary provider of DUV and EUV, EUV being the more advanced technology lithography equipment. And you can see in this market share breakdown, ASML on the far left in purple takes up the most part of that market share bar with a little bit of gray. There are companies like Canon and some smaller niche companies that sell a little bit of lithography for the actual wafer development.
This episode is sponsored by our friends at public.com. Are you dissatisfied with your savings account? Check out public.com.
Public.com has just launched its new high yield cash account, offering an industry leading 5.1% APY. There are no fees, no subscriptions, no minimums or maximums. Just 5.1 interest on your cash. You can transfer or withdraw cash as often as you like, and you get up to $5 million in FDIC insurance. Grow your cash at an industry-leading 5.1% APY with a high-yield cash account at Public. Go to public.com to learn more.
Here's a picture of the NXE system. This is what was the most advanced EUV light system provided by ASML up until just this last year. But we now have this new EXE5000, which Intel took possession of. In fact, they have two machines. It sounds like they're taking possession of their third one later this year. Taiwan Semiconductor Manufacturing supposedly going to be getting one of these sometime this year. Micron, Samsung, SK Hynix, all on the books, expecting to get some of these ultra advanced pieces of equipment that gets the latest generation, this EXE5000 model, almost $400 million a piece. Really big sum of money, something like $50 to $100 million more than the previous gen NXE system.
Not a budget system.
No, not for the spendthrift semiconductor manufacturer. Absolutely not. Which maybe brings us to Intel, which is all of a sudden trying to be a spendthrift. For good reason.
This slide from January of this year, Intel was very proud to have the world's first high NA system delivered from ASML. But things have only deteriorated for Intel. Make sure you catch our video on Intel that we have linked right here in the video. We talked about this specific topic that Intel is laying off 15% of their workforce. So it appears that the high NA equipment is getting moved in and employees are getting moved out.
Yeah, some serious budgeting issues going on with Intel as they feel the pinch from lower product sales, but they still need to build out these fab capacities. So in the Q&A section, CDO Pat Gelsinger talked about some of their technology development roadmap, Intel 4 and Intel 3, those numbers referring to the size of the dimensions on chips in nanometers. Of course, these are marketing terms. The dimensions, the smallest dimensions on their chips are not actually 4 nanometers or 3 nanometers, but at any rate, different topic. And then next year, they're moving into their 18A manufacturing process. That A stands for angstroms. There's 10 angstroms in a nanometer. So basically 1.8 nanometer process technology. This high NA machine that they're taking, the second one's going to Oregon, and again, supposedly a third one on the way, is going to help with their development of later on their 14A and 10A manufacturing processes. Those aren't actually going to begin until like 2026, 2027 timeframe. In the meantime, here's a picture of the EXE5000 from ASML in one of the Intel fabs. this is a really, really expensive, upwards of $400 million each for one of these machines, a very expensive piece of research and development equipment for the next couple of years.
What about the world's leading manufacturer, Taiwan Semiconductor? You mentioned that they do have plans to have this high NA machine placed in one of their facilities later this year, but how are they transitioning with this piece of equipment?
When they do take delivery of one of these EXE5000s, it will also be a piece of R&D equipment for the time being. So it sounds like TSMC, as well as Intel and some other fabs, are still utilizing those NXE systems, and they're probably using multi-patterning techniques to get the job done. At this point, it's all rumors, but I think we could probably safely assume that N3 is using the NXE systems from ASML. N2 is going to begin ramping up production the second half of 2025, which probably means they will continue using the NXE EUV equipment that they already have, or they'll take orders for more of that and continue to use the processes that they've already been developing. And they said that N2 system will begin ramping up the second half of 2025 at a similar pace as N3 has for the last year. So you can see that the pacing of N3 ramp up shown in red in the bar chart on the right. So still a small portion of TSMC's overall revenue, but that will continue to increase. And of course, then we'll get N2 layered in, hopefully by the second half of next year. Now, it sounds like perhaps that could start to change with TSMC's N16 process.
The N16 is the next nano chip based technology. The reason that we need to continue to advance semiconductors is because of the speed and power needed to be provided for things like accelerated compute. And so this N16 will provide a further 8 to 10% speed improvement at the same power, or 15 to 20% power improvement at the same speed. N16 will be best used for specific high-performance compute products with complex signal route and dense power delivery and work. Think generative AI and AI inference.
Yeah, because this is what's scheduled currently for the second half of 2026, this is probably where we will start to see maybe TSMC's introduction of that EXE5000, the machine that has all sorts of shareholders excited, including Intel shareholders up until just recently. Which brings us to the little bit of news that you mentioned, Casey. We have this joint work happening between ASML and IMEC, as well as a little mention from Germany's Zeiss, which is doing some work on the metrology or the measurement equipment.
This news piece came out in June of this year, and ASML and IMEC collaborated to announced the opening of a high-NA EUV lithography lab in Veldhoven in the Netherlands. And this lab will jointly be run by ASML and IMEC. The plan is to allow leading-edge logic and memory chip makers and advanced materials and equipment suppliers access to the prototype of high-NA EUV scanner, which is the twin scan EXE5000, so that they can actually start doing some research and development and see how they can use it in their business.
IMEC, it stands for Inter-University Microelectronics Center. That's a private research and development organization. If you don't know what that is, we have a link below in the description to an Asianometry video where it describes IMEC as the watering hole of the savanna, where all the different animals can come together and collaborate in a nice, friendly environment. So the quick description for what's going on here, this is a lab so the manufacturers can get some help perfecting these very advanced, very complex, very expensive manufacturing steps using these new EXE5000. So the more recent news that came out of this is just a couple months later, IMEC says that it was able to demonstrate successful scanning of silicon wafers using the EXE5000 using single exposure. So this sounds like really boring stuff. I'm sorry, bear with me here for just a moment, Casey. Here's a picture of what some of these patterns actually look like from the IMEC lab. Typically, when we've gotten down to the 20 nanometer and smaller dimension of the semiconductor industry, companies have been using EUV and previously DUV, deep ultraviolet machines from ASML, and they've had to scan the wafers multiple times, often using different templates, different patterns to get the ultimate small shape that they want. Those are called photomasks. In this visual you can see here from Applied Materials photomask generation, there at the top next to EDA, that's the software design portion of this industry.
It's kind of like those tracing sheets that you used as a kid, where you could trace out your name or a picture. It's very similar to that, right?
Yeah, that could be a good way of thinking about it. And then if you could take it maybe one step further, maybe think of this in three dimensions, because after you trace out those lines, it takes several exposures from the lithography machine to get all of the lines that you want on the paper. Think in three dimensions, because patterns that haven't been traced out get removed. And what's left over are those little three-dimensional microscopic cities that make up the circuitry of the semiconductor. So when you have multi-patterning, which you see here in the middle, you have to go through these steps multiple times. You have to deposit the material that chemically reacts with the deep ultraviolet or extreme ultraviolet light. And then the patterns get etched away, and then the wafer gets cleaned, and then you start the step all over again.
So does that mean that multi-patterning is just going away after this development, the single exposure that IMEC announced?
Yeah, that would be the ultimate goal here with the EXE5000, is if you can complete all of those steps with just one single round of exposure from the lithography equipment, that saves a tremendous amount of money if you're a semiconductor manufacturer. So yes, the EXE5000, much more expensive than the previous gen NXE machines, NXE lineup. But if you can figure out a way, like IMEC did, to make all of your patterns with one photomask, one deposition step, one hit with the lithography machine, one etch step, and then the wafer gets cleaned and it moves on in the process, your operating costs could be reduced significantly. So yes, when you look at this at first blush, you would think, okay, ASML is sitting on its next massive wave of growth. Multi-patterning steps of the last few years is going away. Double patterning, or LE, litho-hetch, triple, quadruple patterning, they're going to disappear, right?
It may seem like that at first glance, but we're probably a ways away from that, right?
Yeah. What's actually going to happen in reality is, now that a lot of the kinks have been worked out of this manufacturing process using double patterning and multi-patterning steps, when ASML says that they're going to get this really, really significant wave of growth starting in 2025, like we talked about last month, they're probably just talking about a big wave of NXE, EUV machines, and DUV machines, not so much a massive wave of EXE 5000 orders.
And that makes a lot of sense. $400 million or more of pop for these machines, it prohibits a lot of companies, right? A lot of your capital expenditure would have to go to this. So it still continues to make sense to have these DUV machines or EUV machines, but it still may make sense to use a multi-patterning process for most of these companies, at least at this point, until it gets a little more cost efficient.
Yeah, and this is how all tech works. You have a few early adopters that spend buku bucks and are willing to get their hands on the latest and greatest, and then kind of guinea pig it and work out some of the creases, some of the wrinkles that may be there, perfect it, and then they get to declare technological leadership. And then you have everybody else who's more than happy to adopt the previous generation technology now that it's been perfected. Like you said, it's not so quite so cost prohibitive. they're more than happy to grab hold of that now and then wait for the leaders, TSMC, Intel, Samsung, and some memory makers like Micron and SK Hynix. Go ahead and do your thing with the EXE5000. We'll come in later once you're done with the R&D phase. And so in the meantime, what this means is as the previous gen manufacturing steps using ASML's previous gen EUV machines, as well as the surrounding ecosystem of manufacturing equipment that surrounds that lithography machine, like, for example, all of the Fab Five, all the other four companies in the Fab Five, they're all going to see this wave of growth probably in 2025.
Makes a lot of sense. This is some very exciting news out of IMEC, and it's nice to see that they're making progress on the research and development of this very expensive machine. This definitely could become a large revenue stream for ASML, not this year in 2024, but maybe headed into 2025 and 2026, we could see more revenue progression from this. If you haven't already, make sure you hit the subscribe button. And one company that will benefit from the NXE in 2025 is Lam Research. And that company we're going to be talking about in our next video. We know many of you have been anxiously awaiting the video on their most recent earnings results. So stay tuned.
We will be recording that video on Lam Research here very shortly. If you're a Semiconductor Insider member, you were already able to catch our quarterly earnings take on Lam Research over on our Discord channel. If you can, check that out. It's just $5 a month.
We'll see you again soon at Chipstock Investor.